portions of TV23's Internet provided by SWKO Wireless Internet. Covering the High Plains with news, weather, and information. From TV23 Studios in Sublette, this is High Plains Today.
Hi, everybody. Today is Monday, September 21st, 2015. Welcome to the show, High Plains Today, right here on TV23. On today's show, Marcala Pewthers. She is from the Saints, promoting education careers at Seward County Community College. They're holding a school supply and book drive. We're going to be talking to her about that. Now, let's take a quick look at some news. Well, local Masons will host a free cancer screening during the Stevens County Health Fair Saturday, October 3rd, from 8 to 11 a.m. at the Hugoton Middle School. Now, this is one of 22 free cancer awareness events sponsored across the state this year by the Kansas Masonic Foundation. Screening is open to the public. Now, Kansas Masonic Foundation conducts the screenings in partnership with the Midwest Center Alliance, the outreach division of the University of Kansas Cancer Center, and KU Medical Center medical staff. Now, more than 4,000 Kansas residents have attended the Masonic screenings over the past few years. The event in Hugoton will include skin and prostate cancer screenings, as well as bone density tests and breast cancer information. The Garden City Commission approved the intent to issue revenue bonds of up to $240 million as the next step for a dairy processing plant to be developed near the Jameson Energy Center on the city's south side. Now, the cost for Metalark, a subsidiary of Dairy Farmers of America, for developing the property is $235 million and would be paid back by the company. Now, the plant is expected to open in 2 years and will employ 55 people. And the Lee Richardson Zoo's two African elephants, Missy and Kimba, will be transported to Colorado Springs in the next month or so. The zoo's aging elephants will be leaving Lee Richardson Zoo possibly as early as October, following the City Commission's decision on September 1st to transport them to the Cheyenne Mountain Zoo in Colorado Springs. The decision was made to relocate the elephants largely due to their age and concerns about keeping a solitary animal when one or the other dies. Now, Missy is 46 and Kimba is 33. The Kansas labor force shrank in August, but job vacancies were high, suggesting retirements may be a major factor in slowing job growth. Now, the labor force, which is the number of people employed plus the number looking for work, shrank by 2,955 compared to July and by 25,407 compared to August 2014. That's according to monthly labor market report from the Kansas Department of Labor. The Kansas unemployment rate in August was unchanged from July and slightly higher than a year earlier. The seasonally adjusted rate was 4.6% in August, which was statistically unchanged from July. It had been 4.3% in August of 2014. The Wellington versus Circle High School football game ended approximately 2 minutes early due to a safety concern for student athletes on both sides. Now, with 2 minutes left to play, there was an altercation between student athletes that resulted in an ejection of a Circle player. The score at the time was 58-8 in favor of Wellington. Now, the two teams, along with the officials, decided to end the game at that time. The uninsured rate in Kansas dropped to 10.2% in 2014 as part of a national increase in insurance coverage that appeared due to health care reform. About 12.3% of people in Kansas didn't have insurance in 2013, according to the U.S. Census Bureau's American Community Survey. The drop indicates about 57,000 fewer people were insured in 2014 than in 2013. Now, nationwide, the uninsured rate fell from 14.5% to 11.7%, meaning about 8.5 million more people had insurance than did 1 year earlier. It was the largest drop after several years of a relatively flat rate, according to the Kansas Institute of Health. And finally, Ohio Governor John Kasich emerged as the first Republican presidential candidate to file for the Kansas Presidential Caucus, which requires payment of a $15,000 filing fee. Now, Kasich said in a statement his campaign expected to be competitive in Kansas, which he described as an important state in the national race. I'm thinking they all say that. The Kansas Presidential Caucus for Republicans will be March 5th. It will be conducted at about 95 locations around the state, which haven't been finalized. Each registered Republican voter in Kansas can take part in the caucus at no cost. And that's a look at just some of the news around the area and the state. Stick around. Back with some weather right after this.
You're watching High Plains Today on TV 23 with host Chris Jewell. TV23's internet service and 4G live streaming provided by United Wireless. Coverage you deserve. Service you expect. United Wireless.
Happen. We're here. Your local TV and radio broadcasters. America's number one source for news, weather, and information on every screen in your life. We are broadcasters. Always here for you, wherever here may be. Text TV to 52886. Tell Washington local stations matter.
So, I'm kind of new here, but I've noticed a trend. My human does this funny thing where she goes around and gets all my toys, and then she hides them in that basket by the door. You know, but it's always the same basket, and it's always in the same place. And then she acts so surprised when I find them, but, you know, she's putting them in the same basket again. It's like, hello, that's where you put it last time. You were the worst at hide-and-go-seek.
Now, the local weather forecast for the High Plains.
And welcome back. As we look northeast on the TV 23 tower cam, it's a lovely, sunny day. It was soupy this morning, though. There was a lot of fog out there. And when there's a lot of fog, make sure your lights are on and drive slower. Let's take a look at the readings here at the station. Current temperature, 76 degrees. Relative humidity, 72%. Winds are out of the east-southeast at 9. The barometric pressure, pretty much holding steady. Looking at our current temperatures around the region, everybody except Lamar at 65. I'm not sure. Maybe because they're closer to the mountains. I don't know. Anyway, everybody else pretty much in the 70s. Got a few temperatures down in Perryton, Elkhart, and Guymon in the 80s. Looking at our current dew points, everybody pretty much in the upper 50s to middle 60s. Looking at the current wind speeds, 4. In Liberal, not breezy at all. Everybody else, pretty mild out there as far as the winds are. Not real stout, pretty much everything out of the southerly direction. Looking at our highs and lows, as recorded by the Regional Airport in Garden City, yesterday's high of 83, 98, the record back in 1983. The low of 55 last night, 32 back in 1983. And for the last few days, nothing in the bucket. Looking at our forecast, 91 today. Winds are going to be out of the south-southeast at 14. Going to be a pleasant day. Tonight, 65 for the low. Winds will be out of the south at 13. And then tomorrow, pretty much sunny, 91 degrees for the high. Winds are going to be out of the south. They're going to start picking up afternoon, gusting up to 28. And then tomorrow night, low of 64, but that's going to 30% chance of showers. That's going to happen mainly after midnight into Wednesday morning. Looking at our 7-day, you can see 91 today, 91 tomorrow. Then we're going to drop back off into the 80s just a little bit. Highs are going to be anywhere from the mid-60s to the upper 50s. That's a look at weather. Stick around. We'll be back with markets after this.
Are you tired of worrying about going over your cell phone data cap? Tired of surprise bills and text messages asking for more money? Stop the insanity. Switch to unlimited nationwide data from United Wireless. Switching is easy. Come in today and see for yourself. For a limited time, get free activation, up to $200 per line bill credit, and save on the latest smartphones. See how much you can save with unlimited nationwide data from United Wireless. See store for details.
So, same time next week?
Well, of course.
Put away a few bucks, feel like a million bucks. For free tips to help you save, go to
Feed the Pig.
When some people struggle with their mortgage payments, they become frozen, petrified, not knowing what to do. They do nothing. But the people who do something, the people who take action, are far more likely to get the most positive outcome. Making Home Affordable is a free government program. Call now to talk one-on-one with a housing expert about the options that are right for you. Real help, real answers, right now.
Thank you.
For those dealing with the daily struggles of caring for a loved one, we hear you. That's why AARP created a community with experts and other caregivers to help us better care for ourselves and the ones we love.
And welcome back to High Plains Today, right here on TV 23. I am now joined in studio by Ms. Marcala Pewthers. She is a sophomore at Seward County Community College, and she is a member of, I got to get this right because I wrote it down, Saints Promoting Education Careers. Mm-hmm. Did I get that right?
Yes, you got it right.
Man, that's a lot. That is a very, very lot. Mm-hmm. How are you today?
I'm doing good. How are you?
Good. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
All right. Now tell me a little bit about SPEC. We're just going to call it SPEC.
Okay. Well, what SPEC is it's a club at Seward County Community College, and it's for education majors. And I think the purpose of the club is to help those who are education majors get a little bit more experience of working with kids, as well as just teaching them a little bit more about what the profession is and stuff like that.
To make sure that you want to deal with those little kids, if you
yes.
want to, especially if you, well, I guess it really wouldn't matter if you want to go into education at all to kind of get just a little bit, little taste of it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So let me ask you this before okay. we get into the real reason you're here, though. In this club, do you guys get to have any? I mean, what kind of experiences do you have dealing with kids and those types of things? Kind okay. of getting you ready. For
okay.
education.
Well, a lot of what we do is have kids come to the college, and one of our events that we did last semester was we had kids come to the college and we read books to them, and we'll be doing that again in December. It's called Tis the Season, and in order to come, you have to sign up for it, so you'd have to talk to our sponsor, but we pretty much just get the kids into groups of grade levels, and then we read books to them, and then there's also games and cookies. So.
Can I sign up? There's cookies.
Yeah.
I would be there for the cookies.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So what age kids are you working with in this deal?
Usually grade school.
Okay.
So anywhere from preschool to third grade. There's some older kids, but not very many that come, usually.
All right. So the real reason, though,
okay.
you guys have a school supply and book drive
mm-hmm.
going on right now through Thursday, maybe?
The 24th.
Yes. Okay.
Yes.
All right. I thought I had that right.
Yes. We're doing a school supply and book drive. It's for the students at Washington Elementary. And we're just asking for school supplies such as pencils, markers, crayons, stuff like that, scissors, glue sticks, just things that the school needs for the kids to be able to be involved.
And the books that you're looking for are just about any kind of book, but they have to be in fairly good shape, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, you don't want them bringing any wood covers hanging on.
Pretty much new or gently used books, children's books, of course, and then probably in age ranges from preschool to third grade level. So.
Gently used.
Gently
I like
used.
That description. Gently used. That's a good answer. Good answer. So how did you guys get involved with Washington Elementary?
Our sponsor talked to the principal at Washington Elementary, Tracy Metlin, mm-hmm. and she told us about the need for school supplies, which I know it's everywhere in Liberal, but we just wanted to go with one specific school. And she also talked about the need for books. A lot of the students at their school grow up in homes where there are no books. So it's just a great opportunity for us to reach somebody in our community at least.
So how have you got, I mean, do you have different places around campus, around town, or where people can donate?
Yes, we actually have, our last meeting, we decorated boxes and we have them placed around campus. There's one in the administrative office and one in the library in the actual academic building at the college. And then we have one in the humanities building and also one in the student union building.
So you have these four locations around campus.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if I had some stuff at my house, mm-hmm. and I went, oh, I should donate this stuff. would I be able to just bring them out to the campus and
yes.
go ahead and donate them also?
Mm-hmm.
So you don't just have to be associated with Seward County Community College to do this.
No, you can just come in there and put them in one of our boxes.
So is this something that you guys, do you guys look for a project like this every year, or do you change
yes,
projects?
Yes, we do something every year to give back to our community and just also to help us with helping the next generation. So last year we also did a school supply drive, and then we did a couple other events throughout the year.
What were the other? Give me an example of another event.
Okay,
you guys did.
We did the reading again last
year.
Okay,
yes.
And then we also did Trick or Treat Street, which is we'll have a couple hundred kids come through and we get to play a game with them. There's a bunch of booths out there, so.
So you do this where in the union?
In the union building at the college.
All right, so if I come to 'tis the season to get read to, if I sign up for that and trick or treat, mm-hmm. I can get cookies and candy.
Yes.
All right. So Marcala, all right, here's the big question. Now this is a good thing. How many members are there in your club that do this?
There's probably around 10 of us.
You're all interested in making education your career.
Mm-hmm. The majority of us are, and most of us are elementary education, leaning towards that. There are a few in high school and middle school, but not very many.
Good for you guys.
Yeah.
Good for you. All right, now here's my big question in the minute or so that we have left.
Okay.
What made you want to be in elementary education?
Well, I started college, and I wasn't sure what I wanted to major, and it's a big decision, and so I thought about it quite a bit my first semester, and then come my second semester I'm like, well, I need to decide. I don't want to just be going to school spending money for nothing. So I looked at what I had been doing for the past 2 years. I had worked with the babysitting, and I just love working with kids. I work with kids at my church, and my dad's a teacher, so I just thought, well, maybe I'll try out teaching.
You come by this naturally then,
yes.
don't you?
Yes.
Well, good for you. So, and then after you get done at Seward County this mm-hmm. year, then you're going to move on to a four-year university.
Yes.
But you're not sure where you're going to go yet.
No, I'm not sure. I'm debating. I've thought about OSU. Because my dad went to school there, but
I know, and your dad is a former wrestling coach.
Yes.
So yeah, that's the only reason he picked that is because it's a wrestling school.
And then I've also thought about Emporia because mm-hmm. it's a very good education school, and then OPSU. Just keeping my options open for now.
Okay. Yeah, it's not something you got to decide today,
no.
right? You got a week or two.
Yeah, a week or two.
Well, Marcala, I thank you for coming up today. And if anybody has anything they want to donate, get it out to Seward County Community College. Gently used or new
yes.
books, school supplies, pencils, markers. Mm-hmm. What am I leaving out? It's been a long time since I've been in school.
Scissors, rulers, crayons. Anything
glue,
like
glue
sticks.
I forgot.
Yes. Yes.
And don't eat the glue.
No.
Just take the glue sticks out to the college,
yeah.
right? Did you ever eat glue when you were a kid?
I
know I didn't. I was a perfect student when I was in school. I didn't eat glue.
No, I didn't eat glue.
All right, good for you. So, you got anything to donate, get it out to Seward County Community College and help these young ladies out as they prepare for a career in education, right?
Mm-hmm.
Marcala, thank you for coming in today.
Thank you for having me.
All right. And stick around. I'll be back with some sports and stuff after this. Hi, Chris Jewell, host of High Plains Today, a 30-minute news and information program that airs weekdays at noon right here on TV 23. We talk about news, we talk about sports, we talk about weather, we're even going to talk entertainment. We'll have live guests right here on set with me. So, every day at noon, tune in, High Plains Today. We'll see you then.
Weekdays here on TV 23.
You want to feel connected, at one with your world. Informed, included, and inspired. So no matter where you are, when important things happen, we're here at all hours, in the moment, on every screen in your life. Your local TV and radio broadcasters. We investigate and inform, give back to the community, build the local economy, even save lives. America's number one source for news, weather, and information. And unlike any other news source, we're here. 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 And here. We are broadcasters. Always here for you. Wherever here may be. Text TV to 52886. Tell Washington local stations matter.
Did you know kids who play outdoors have healthier lungs?
Totally.
Did you know that boys that play with dolls make better husbands?
My son has lots of dolls. But did you know terrycloth diapers breathe better?
I did.
Mm-hmm. It's totally true.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Did you guys know statistically friendly kids have more friends?
Yeah.
That's obvious.
Did you know most people think they're using the right car seat for their kid, but they're not?
Parents who really know it all know for sure that their child is in the right seat. Visit safercar.gov/the right seat to make sure your child is protected.
And welcome back. Hey, I'm Marcala. Nice young lady. Let's take a look at some scores from Friday night local football games. Now, Dodge City lost to Wichita Heights 53-48. That was close. But Garden City, they beat Great Bend in their first WAC game 42-28. Liberal lost to Hayes in a WAC contest 29-0. Ulysses, they took it to number one ranked Holcomb 34-20. Hukaton beat Colby 27-8. Scott City beat Goodland 42-14. Meade put a thumping on Southwestern Heights 49-0. And Sublette lost to Cimarron 88-27. Lakin hosted Elkhart and lost 15-14. Leota beat Stanton County 16-12. That is two close games. South Gray beat Fowler 50-0. And Satanta lost to South Central 48-14. Rolla traveled out to Springfield, Colorado, and lost 52-14. The Kansas State Wildcat football squad moved to 3-0 after a battle with Louisiana Tech. K-State's offense struggled with third down conversions, down 10-6 at halftime. Louisiana Tech nailed a 45-yard field goal, and that ended a 23-23 tie. Three overtimes, K-State 39-33. Let's take a look at our weather. 78 degrees out there right now. Relative humidity 69%. Winds are out of the south-southeast at 7. Yep, barometric pressure. You guessed it, still holding steady. Looking at our 7-day, you can see there is a chance of rain rolling in on Tuesday and Wednesday, but that's going to happen well after midnight on Tuesday into Wednesday morning. Highs in the 80s, lows in the 50s and 60s. Go out and make it a super Monday. See you back here tomorrow.
Oh, yeah. Keep up to date with the latest information from TV 23 on our Facebook page, KDGL-TV.
Same time next week?
Well, of course. Put away a few bucks, feel like a million bucks. For free tips to help you save, go to Feed the Pig.
Something I feel when I'm right.